So I thought it would be helpful just to see somebody who genuinely doesn't know what they're doing. So if you clicked on this video, you're probably looking to apply to school at FIT for the fashion design program. And that's what I will be walking you through the process of me building my portfolio in this video. I have applied to Pratt and the School of the Art Institute of Chicago for their fashion programs, and I have gotten into both of them, but the portfolio was very different. It was more of just regular artwork pieces that you just put together. And when I got to the FIT portfolio, I noticed that it was very different. Obviously, it's fashion design, which I had no experience whatsoever in. And so I watched a bunch of YouTube videos and learned so much, just seeing different people's portfolios and what they put into it. But I never saw anybody walk through the actual process of them making their portfolio. It was just pictures of what they had done. And I thought it would be really cool to film a video of someone's actual thought process behind it, behind their portfolio while they were making it. And also, another part was I have absolutely no experience. I had done only two fashion drawings before I started my portfolio, and I didn't finish either of them. And also, a lot of times in the videos that I was watching, people had been going into the city for years and like taking courses or like summer classes where they were getting help building a portfolio and talking with professors. And I've had no access to anything like that. I live in a very rural area. And so I thought it would be helpful just to see somebody who genuinely doesn't know what they're doing to walk through this. And so I have completed my portfolio, I sent it in, and I have been accepted into FIT for the fashion program for fall of 2022. And so I would like to share with you guys how I created my portfolio. And yeah. So basically, for the portfolio, there's different parts. There's the mix and match fashion design. There's the, which includes a mood board. There's the art fashion design. So just pieces that you've done. The third part is your two sewing projects that you've done, and then an essay. And so I'm gonna start with the mood board for the mix and match because from the videos that I've watched, they've all said that the mood board kind of sets the tone for your whole portfolio because it should be one cohesive piece of work. Even though FIT doesn't tell you to do this, it just shows a level of research that you've done, and it also just shows that you can create a cohesive piece of work. And so that's what we will be starting with today. Okay, so what I'm doing right now is to start my mood board, I'm just going on Pinterest and finding pictures I want to use for it. I kind of know that I wanted to do mine for a fall winter collection kind of vibe. So I think that's important to choose and figure out like which season you want your that your portfolio would be good for. So
Okay, so it's a while later. This is what I ended up with for my mood board. There's a page with colors on it too, but it's not super interesting. But yeah. And now that I have it all together, this is what it looks like. I might add in some of the blue from that center picture as one of the colors on the side. But I'm pretty happy with where it's at now. But yeah.
Okay, so this is what I actually ended up doing for the mood board. I took out the colors on the side because not all of them were seen in the clothing that I did. So, yeah.
Okay, so right now I'm working on the flats, I think that's what they're called, for the designs, for the mix and match. As of right now, I only have the jacket and the pants done. So I kind of started out with this. I'm not using that one. But that's what I have for that. And then I started to draw on the models. So this is what I have so far. I need to add more shading to her jacket. I still haven't figured out what I'm gonna do for the pant color, whether I wanna do like a monochrome look or like a beige-ish. But yeah, that's where I am at right now, so. Okay, so I ended up changing my painting. My sketch. What I had was this. And I like the concept, but I feel like I just painted it very messy. And then also, I don't know, there was just some things about the jacket I didn't like. So I redid it on this page. I just made it, give it a cleaner look, and just painted with a little more caution. And I like this a lot better. I'm gonna add some earrings with some gold paint, but that's where I'm at right now, and I'm very happy with it because now I have the shirt, the jacket, and the pant done. Now for my next shine, all I have to do is the skirt. So okay, so I'm officially done with the mix and match. I just finished up the flats for this one. And then for the fabrics the other day, I went to the store and I just found ones that look similar to what I had wanted and just took a picture of what it was made out of and like the different percentages and the name of it on the side of the fabric, which made that very easy. And then for the leather, I wasn't able to find that. So I just went online and found a scanned image of a leather fabric, and as you can see, it's different than like a regular photo because you can see the texture in it. But yeah, that's where I'm at right now. So I've moved on to the next part, which is the fashion artwork, and I forgot to video me doing these and talking about what was going on. But for this one, I just kind of went off the same vibe from my mix and match and used some elements from the skirt and the jacket and just changed it around a little bit. But yeah, and then for this one, I wanted to do something for just like a heavy winter coat, and I kept that same theme of the like layering of the fabrics. But yeah, as of right now, this one's my favorite. And I put it with like a satin kind of shirt, just to contrast the harsh material. But that's where I'm at right now, and I am working on the next one. So this is what I have going on so far. For the next drawing, I have to think of one more idea and paint both of them and just throw the swatch on there, and then I should be good. Also, normally before I paint, I will basically erase the whole image that I drew just so the lines don't show through and stuff. And I also have a picture on my phone from when it was fully drawn, just in case I forget or some of the lines are too hard to see, just so it looks clean. Okay, so it's the next day and I just finished this one up. I'm happy with how it turned out. I ended up using that satin fabric or the satin texture fabric. It's the same as that one. It looks really different in a different light. But yeah, and then for the pant, I just used a twill and I found this one on the internet. And then you can see it's kind of textured, so yeah. So this is what I've done so far. I have one more. We are on the home stretch, so I'm very excited about that. Okay, so I'm on my last piece. This is what I've got right now. I'm doing a sheer skirt and blouse, and then, I don't know, I think I might use like the tank top from my Mix and Match project. I don't know, I might make it black, I might make it tan. Not sure yet, but that's where I'm at, and I'm about to go paint it right now, so yeah. Okay, this is the final look for this piece. I forgot to take videos, as always, so there's just a picture. And I like it a lot. It matches one of my sewing projects a little bit, so yeah.
Okay, so for the sewing portion of the portfolio, I forgot to film anything that I did. Because one of the pieces I had done quite a while ago, and then the other one I just completely forgot. But I did make a TikTok, so I'll have that in the next clip. Bring it to the hood, baby, and bring it back to the hood, yeah. This is like I feel like in the nighttime. Bust it up and show it when the light shine. Okay, so you get the point. I made a shirt. This is the first shirt I've ever made, and I'm not very good at sewing, but I'm pretty happy with how it turned out. It got some front and back pictures, and then I also have a little picture of the sleeve just to show detail. And then for my other project that I did a long time ago, I did this hat. The pictures are, like, really bad. Trust me, I turned in better ones. Or not. I don't know. I can't remember. But
I am starting to work on my essay right now for the portfolio. It has an essay in it, so it has to be 250 words or less. And I'm supposed to provide an example when my viewpoint differed from a teacher or employer during an evaluation of my performance. How did you handle this situation? So it took me a very long time to think of what I wanted to write about, because this hasn't really happened to me in school much, but I did think of one, so I'm going to talk about. I did an internship for architecture, and it was very interesting, and because there was a lot of, like, criticism that we were given after we do work and just show what we did. It was a student internship, and so I am going to talk about that and how I dealt with the criticism that I faced there, and how at first I was really hostile to it, but then I took it and used it and to make my projects better, and just, yeah.
Essay is done. I need to have my dad look over it, but it took like 20 minutes, maybe 30, I don't know.
Okay, if you made it to the end of the video, thank you so much. I'm finishing up editing it right now. It's June, so it's taken me absolutely forever. So, if I could give 3 points or like tips or pieces of advice before doing this, I would say don't start with only 2 weeks to do it like I did. Give yourself time to just think and like pace yourself. Second, I would say watch a bunch of like runway shows, or just like look at pictures of runway shows when you're doing your drawings, because that really helped me looking at how like the clothing moved on, or like how it looked while it was moving on the models. And then lastly, I would say if you're not experienced, just try it. It's like, it was really fun to do, and I got in, so yeah. So thanks for watching this video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up. And if you didn't, If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. And maybe subscribe, because this is my first video. So, yeah.